Hello, everyone, and welcome to another exciting week of Ultimate Championship Wrestling. I am the overnight sensation, Lemmy Cantrell, flying solo with you tonight on commentary. Right now, we've got the Viper Pete Christie making his way down to the ringside. He's going to have a lot to talk about as he and Bull Wheeler have got a shot to take the tag team titles from Mayhem tonight in our main event. Let's go to ringside with Viper Pete Christie.
Just Hey, shut up, horse cat. I didn't know they let sweat hogs in here. Oh, sit down, horse cat, before I knock your teeth out. So there's no problem, Pete. You got a play battle shot. Maybe you'll win. Maybe you'll win, but I doubt
it.
Just moments ago, we saw the Exchange lay a brutal beatdown on the Viper Pete Christie. Viper Pete Christie, of course, along with Bull Wheeler, going to challenge for the tag team titles that Mayhem hold here tonight. Exchange obviously trying to soften up Pete Christie. But the tag titles are not the only title on the line tonight, as the Cruiserweight Championship is up for grabs. Sky Devin defending against their former champion, Jason Young. Up next, though, we've got two cruiserweights coming to the ring, two up-and-comers. We've got Tommy Titus and Sebastian Rose ready to get it on right now on Ultimate Championship Wrestling.
And nothing but a good time is all Sebastian Rose is out for here tonight, looks like, as he comes out with a bottle of Jack Daniels in his hand. Well, what's left of the bottle of Jack Daniels? The rest of it's got to be resting settled in his gut, as he seems to be mighty inebriated out here. That's the sort of thing you're supposed to do after you win a match, not beforehand. You come out to the ring drunk, you're setting yourself up to be an easy target, especially for a man like Tommy Titus. Now, my broadcast colleague was here tonight. Brian Bishop was here tonight. He'd elaborate on the physique of Tommy Titus in ways that would make you think twice about his masculinity. Brian Bishop is not here tonight. Just me, Lemmy Cantrell, calling the play-by-play for you here tonight. And we're going to start off with this matchup between Sebastian Rose and Tommy Titus. We had two very conflicting styles here. Obviously, as Tommy Titus is big into fitness. Probably catch him drinking a protein shake or a Gatorade in the back. Sebastian Rose, on the other hand, be hard-pressed to find him without something alcoholic in his hand to drink. Sebastian Rose saying he doesn't feel too good. I can see why after drinking that much of a bottle of Jack Daniels. Referee's lucky he didn't get puked all over right there. Two men locking up center of the ring. Titus shoves him off, showing his strength superiority over Rose. Also showing his advantage in equilibrium, as Rose has just about no equilibrium right now, stumbles out of the corner. Almost using Tommy Titus right now as a way to steady himself. Rose fires out with a forearm to the face. Now he's taking it to Tommy Titus in the corner. Stiff kicks to the gut, followed by a boot choke. Titus whipped across the ring, comes back into a harsh clothesline by Sebastian Rose. Rose now removing his t-shirt, probably expecting the ladies in the audience to get all hot and bothered by it. Didn't seem to pop him much, though. Titus explodes out of the corner of the clothesline. Titus whips Rose across the ring, back elbow. Rose clutching his neck there on the mat after getting hit with that huge elbow from Tommy Titus. Tommy Titus hits that vertical suplex, now hitting an elbow drop. Make that two. Tommy Titus brings Sebastian Rose up to his feet, readies him for a body slam off the ropes now with a leg drop. You notice he was holding Sebastian Rose upside down for an extended period before hitting that body slam, hoping to get all the blood, all that alcohol-saturated blood rushing to the head of Sebastian Rose. Rose, though, still able to get in some offensive maneuvers, kicking away at the leg of Tommy Titus, now instituting a leg grapevine. Make that two. And now he's cinching this one in, grapevining the left leg of Tommy Titus around his own leg. Referee asking Tommy Titus if he wants to give up here. Titus, however, refuses. Leg bar now instituted by Sebastian Rose. Grabbing that second rope for extra leverage, trying to hyperextend that knee. He knew the referee wasn't looking at that time and he could get away with it. Titus using his strength to pull himself to that bottom rope, get the five count going. Sebastian Rose has to let go to avoid a disqualification. Rose now has him pinned up in the corner and kicks Tommy Titus's leg over the second rope. Now he's just wailing away at the upper body and head of Tommy Titus in the corner. Whip across to the other corner. Rose charges in, hits that clothesline, whips him back across to the original corner, dives in, misses the avalanche splash. Titus now going to work on Rose in the corner. Pulling him out into the middle of the ring, hitting a great standing drop kick. All sorts of elevation. Got 6 feet worth of elevation there on Sebastian Rose. Got him right in the head despite that bad leg. Side rushing leg sweep. Hooks that leg, only gets a two count out of it though. Sebastian Rose with a thumb to the eye to regain the advantage. Now going right back after that left leg. Hey, hits the chop block, then a kick to the back of the knee. Now grapevining that leg once again. Trying to twist that knee. Woo! Sebastian Rose calling for Tommy Titus to be taken to school. Now he's taking him there with that figure four leg lock, one of the most feared submission maneuvers in the industry. Rose grabbing that rope, once again working to hyperextend that knee. Referee catches him this time, gives him a warning, makes him break the hold. Rose backing Titus up, whipping him across the ropes. Big errant swing over the top of Titus's head, allows Titus to come back with a forearm smash, followed by a gut buster. And we may see some vomit here. Titus bomb. He's got the pinfall. No, he doesn't. Kick out at two. Titus calling for the fans to cheer him on. Titus going for the sunset flip. Rose holding steadfast though. He drops down on his face, grabs the ropes for good measure, and gets a three count. Sebastian Rose snatches victory from the jaws of defeat. Took some major offensive maneuvers from Tommy Titus. Able to sneak away with a victory though, for reversing that sunset flip attempt. Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Referee switch at the request of Jason Yang, and I gotta say, this is a change for the better. And I gotta wonder who this gorgeous woman is coming down to ringside. I think I heard Jason Yang say the name Jade. This Jade, definitely more pleasant to look at than our usual stock of referees, I gotta tell you that much. Jason Yang complaining about being discriminated against by other referees. Brings out this Jade. Apparently because he thinks that she'll be a little less biased against him. I haven't seen a bias in the past, but apparently Jason Yang feels he has been discriminated against, especially in his last encounter where he lost the Cruiserweight title to Sky Devin. Sky Devin right here, your Cruiserweight champion. Having to succumb to the rematch clause in Jason Yang's contract. Give Jason Yang the rematch for the Cruiserweight title. Sky Devin defeated Jason Yang for last week here on Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Yang looking to recapture the gold. Sky Devin looking to put Yang down for good here. We'll be right back with this Cruiserweight title match on Ultimate Championship Wrestling. And welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Sky Devin, the Cruiserweight champion, has got a huge advantage right now over Jason Yang. Drop kick him out of the ring, as you can see in this fast motion footage of the chain wrestling that they had going earlier on. Sky Devin was firmly in control there, and he's firmly in control now. Jason Yang on the outside of the ring, trying to regain his composure, take a little bit of a break. Jade.
Get in here!
Counting Yang out, giving him enough time where he can recover on the outside. Sky Devin through waiting, though. He slides right out of the ring, chasing Jason Yang around. Yang slides back in, lures Devin right into his trap. Exactly what Jason Yang was waiting for. Waiting for Jason Yang to come out, or for Sky Devin to come out and expose himself, giving Jason Yang the advantage. And Jason Yang takes the advantage, hitting that vertical suplex, going for a pinfall, but only getting two off of it. Now he's cinching in a one-handed choke down on the mat. Yang brings Devin to his feet. Martial arts uppercut, sending Yang over the second rope. These two men know each other very well. Battled numerous times already here in Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Jade chastising Sky Devin for those closed fists that allows Jason Yang to come back. Hit a double axe handle smash. Kick away at Sky Devin down on the mat. Yang scoop slam on Devin. Off the second rope now with a springboard leg drop. Hook in the leg, but only gets a two count. Yang upset that they only got a two count. Backs Sky Devin in the corner. It's two. Chops across the chest. Now a two-handed choke. Kick to the ribs. And another one. Yang coming in with that toe kick. Bending, doubling Sky Devin over. Irish whip reversed by Devin. Devin hits a spinning wheel kick. Oh, enziguri. You can hear the clap of that enziguri smacking across the back of Jason Yang's head. But it still only gets a two count. Yang now taken to the corner by Devin. He eats some turnbuckle pad. Now he's being slapped across the chest by our reigning cruiserweight champion, Sky Devin. Devin rolling thunder shoulder block into the corner, scooping him up. Got him up in a fireman's carry. Now he's dropping Yang down with a Death Valley driver. And this match might be over right here. Devin, though, not going for the pinfall. Devin is going for the second rope. Oh, he's going even higher now. He's up on the top rope, steadying himself, leaping off with a huge elbow across the throat, hooking that near leg. It gets a one count, but Jade apparently breaking one of her nails. See this again. Huge Death Valley driver delivered there, then off the top rope with the elbow. That could have been all. Jade broke a nail during the pinfall attempt. Wasn't able to continue the count. Yang now back up to his feet. Using Devin's own arm to hit a neck breaker on him. Great use of your opponent's body against him there by Jason Yang, who by a miracle of fortune is still alive in this Cruiserweight title match. We once again see this neck breaker by Jason Yang. Chops across the chest now, and a thrust to the throat. Devin, though, blocks a big right hand and delivers one of his own. Blocks another one. Jade already chastised him earlier for those closed fists. Modified SDF being cinched in by Cruiserweight champion Sky Devin. Jade, though, calling it a choke. That was close to call. Could have was somewhere between a chin lock and a choke. Could have been taken either way. Jade erring to the side of safety, making Sky Devin break that hold. Scoop up, sidewalk slam. Really slow two count there by Jade. As this match continues, Devin arguing the speed of that count by Jade as he continues to dominate Jason Yang. Usually these two are much more even in their contest. Devin now going for the second rope. Yang's back up to his feet. Powerbomb! Powerbomb from the second rope. Using his leverage, putting his feet up on the ropes and getting the three count. Quick three count by Jade. And the Asian Sensation regains the Cruiserweight title. I'll tell you, any discrimination against Yang in the past that may have happened, more than made up for in this match by Jade. Seemed to be clearly biased towards Jason Yang. But you know what? I would be more outraged, but you know what? This Jade, still good change from our normal referees, if you ask me. And welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Here comes PJ Flowers getting ready to host his weekly segment, The Flower Shop. Assaulting PJ Flowers. Pierce Masters slamming PJ Flowers in the head with that microphone, and somebody just jumped in the ring chasing up the Connecticut Experience. I think I recognize that guy. That's Josh Abercrombie. Josh Abercrombie, a well-known professional wrestler from around these parts. Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. We had an impromptu tag team match being scheduled right now. Due to that conflict from just a few moments ago during the flower shop. Can I experience lashing out at PJ Flowers? Out comes this Josh Abercrombie to save the day. And now it's Pierce Masters and Daniel Sigma, the Connecticut Experience, going up against these two friends, PJ Flower and Josh Abercrombie, calling themselves the Rainbow Warriors, and I don't think it's after the University of Hawaii either. Abercrombie springboard into a spin kick to the face on Pierce Masters. Connecticut Experience huddling together, trying to regain their composure on the outside. Here comes Abercrombie, though, who flips over the top rope. 360 degrees of rotation, kicking both members in the head, knocking them both down. Let's get a second look at that. Abercrombie pinning Masters in the corner in a very precarious position. Sigma making the save, though, luckily for Masters. He was in a very precarious position there for a moment. Masters now with a knee to the gut drags Abercrombie over to the Connecticut Experience corner. Tags in Daniel Sigma. Sigma kicking Matt Abercrombie down on the mat, delivering a elbow to the back. Scooping him up, hitting Abercrombie with a slam. Sigma sending to the top rope, sitting on it, now back on the second rope, diving off with an elbow smash. Somewhat of a cocky pin there by Sigma. I think it's a two count. Front face lock by Sigma, tags out to Masters. Masters in the ring now, unloads with the right hand of the gut. Front face lock into a very quick vertical suplex. Should be making a cover here, but he doesn't. Instead, he continues the assault with an elbow drop. Now a cover, but doesn't hook the leg. No leg hook, no three count. That can almost guarantee you every time. Masters misses a clothesline attempt. Every time he goes behind with the schoolboy roll-up. PJ Flowers does a version of that he calls the fruit roll-up from hell. Don't even want to speculate as to why. Abercrombie wrapping around, gets that crucifix. Crucifix pin attempt, only gets two. Now he's going for a sunset flip. Masters sits down right on his face, but thinks better of it immediately afterwards. Doesn't even want to sit there long enough to try to get a three count. Sigma into the ring. Kicks Abercrombie in the shoulder, takes back out to Masters. Masters back in, elbow to the shoulder. Connecticut Experience obviously got a game plan working here. Obviously going after that left arm of Josh Abercrombie. Abercrombie comes back, reversing a power slam attempt into a reverse DDT. Now ducking a clothesline, rolling, and getting that tag to PJ Flowers. PJ Flowers, freshest man in this match right now, in this ring, taking it to Pierce Masters right now. Whip across the ropes, blind tag by Sigma there, as you can see. PJ Flowers didn't see it, however. Now both members of Connecticut Experience into the ring, hitting a double flapjack on PJ Flowers. Daniel Sigma, now your legal man, hooking the leg this time, nearly getting the three count. This is going to put a kink in the Connecticut Experience's plans here, as they were going after the left arm of Josh Abercrombie. Now Abercrombie's out of this match. Connecticut Experience going to have to find some way to exploit PJ Flowers here. Sigma tags out to Masters. Masters steps in, delivers a kick to PJ Flowers. Masters goading Abercrombie into the ring. This allows both members of the Kinetic Experience to get in the ring at the same time. Now they're going to deliver a double vertical suplex to PJ Flowers. Covered by Sigma. Gets a two count only. Sigma bringing Flowers up to his feet, slamming the back of his head right down to the mat, making a cover, this time without hooking the leg. That's not going to get it done. Sigma is not nearly big enough of a man to pin anyone without hooking their leg first. Whip across the ring by Sigma. Sigma diving in right into a back elbow. Now he drives in again. He charged in again, that time to a big boot, but he hits a huge Arn Anderson style spine buster. That could be all. Abercrombie breaks it up, however. Sigma drags Flowers to the corner, tags out to Masters. Masters in with a punch to the breadbasket, doubling PJ Flowers over, bringing him right down to his hands and knees. Now a knee to the breadbasket, off the ropes by Masters. Masters twists the neck, hits a very technical spinning neck breaker there. Technically sound, I should say. Everything about this Connecticut Experience is very technically sound. Their entire style just oozes with a kind of ring savvy that you usually see in guys who have been in this business far longer. But these guys are young kids, and already they're both ring generals. DDT by Flowers. Flowers had been taking quite a beating there. And this could be the opportunity he needs now to tag out, just as Abercrombie earlier needed an opportunity to tag out to Flowers. Now Flowers desperately needs this tag to Abercrombie. Abercrombie looks refreshed out there after taking a few minutes off. Abercrombie is tagged in, as does Daniel Sigma. Abercrombie beats him to the punch, or to the clothesline rather, and hits a clothesline on Masters as well. Knocks them both down a second time. Now seems to be calling for a double head smash, and he throws their heads together like they're curling in Moe. Kick to the stomach, off the ropes. Two count after that inverted neck breaker there. Abercrombie still on the offensive, though. He still has the advantage. Oh, but Sigma takes it right back with a jawbreaker. Misses a swing. Reverse flatliner. Abercrombie hit that reverse flatliner. Should have went for the pin right there. That could have been all. But he tags in Flowers instead. Flowers now hoisting Sigma up to his shoulders. Off the ropes. And a three count. A three count. After this very unique maneuver here. But Masters in the ring now. And he nails both members of the Rainbow Warriors with that steel chair. Variation of the Crippler Crossface being cinched in on PJ Flowers. And now Daniel Sigma with a camel clutch on Josh Abercrombie. Take another look at this maneuver. It's like a spine buster into a double backbreaker right into the kidneys of Daniel Sigma. That gets a three count for the Rainbow Warriors, but the two men walking out of the ring are the Connecticut Experience, and the two men laying in the middle are the Rainbow Warriors. And we'll be right back.
So far tonight, we've seen a lot of action in the ring. PJ Flowers and Josh Abercrombie defeated the Connecticut Experience just moments ago. But the Connecticut Experience left the Rainbow Warriors land in the middle of the ring. Also, we've seen the Cruiserweight title change hands yet again, going back to Jason Young, who reclaimed the title by defeating Sky Devon. Later on tonight, we've got our huge main event, tag team titles on the line, Mayhem defending against Pete Christie and Bull Wheeler, two hometown boys, ready to perform in front of the Bay City crowd. Pete Christie, of course, suffered that massive beatdown earlier tonight. Off the hands of the Exchange. The Exchange looking to eliminate another one of their enemies, the $10,000 bounty. Dave DuPont offering $10,000 to whoever can take out Justin Rowe. The man who answered that call tonight is
is the Milwaukee Mall.
And there's our former heavyweight champion, Justin Rhodes, going through the crowd. Just as Sebastian Rhodes did earlier, except for Rhodes isn't being accompanied by that bottle of Jack Daniels. Instead, he's being accompanied by his Texas bull rope there, as you can see in his left hand. Our former heavyweight champion getting ready to go one-on-one with the Milwaukee Mahler. Mahler taking up a $10,000 bounty being offered by Dave DuPont. Milwaukee Mahler can take out Justin Rhodes here. Dave DuPont calls Justin Rhodes a thorn in the side of the exchange. The exchange tried to take him out last week unsuccessfully. They did take his heavyweight title off of him. The Barbarian is now our heavyweight champion. But Rhodes was back on later that night. Later that same night, he came through, participated in that six-man bunkhouse brawl match. Now Dave DuPont wants him put out of commission for good, and he has enlisted the services of the Milwaukee Mahler, one of the biggest, baddest men ever to step foot into a wrestling ring. And there he is, Milwaukee's best, the Milwaukee Mahler, making his way out to the ring. He's not a fan favorite here in Bay City, but I'm sure he could care less what the fans think of.
Justin Rhodes, I plan on kicking that $10,000 with your hide right now.
Milwaukee Mahler promising to take the $10,000 out of Justin Rhodes' hide. Can he do it? We'll find out when we come back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Justin Rhodes clotheslining Milwaukee Mahler right out of the ring. He does a full 360-degree turnaround. Lands on his ass on the outside. Justin Rhodes been dominating the early part of this matchup between these two behemoths. Let's watch that clothesline over the top one more time. Milwaukee Mahler unsteadily walking around the outside of the ring, trying to regain his composure. Rhodes has been taking it to him thus far in this match. Mahler, however, delivers the hangman over the top rope. And immediately he takes to the offensive. He's smothering the face of our former heavyweight champion into the canvas. One-handed choke instituted by the Milwaukee Mahler, gets a five count to break it, and he does in time to save himself from disqualification. Milwaukee Mahler choking the life out of Justin Rhodes over that second rope. Once again, gets a five count to break it, and he does just before five count. And those huge legs of the Milwaukee Mahler over the back of the head of Justin Rhodes, driving his trachea into that second rope. Mahler now seems to be taking to abusing Justin Rhodes' throat, trying to crush that windpipe. As you can see right there with that boot choke, right into the trachea, trying to cut off his wind. It's a very sound strategy there by the Milwaukee Mahler, because you know, if a man cannot breathe, he cannot fight. Off the ropes. Huge clothesline right across the throat. Hey, one more time by the Milwaukee Mahler. Scoop slam now. With authority by the Milwaukee Mahler. Driving all the air, all remaining air out of Justin Rhodes. Rhodes still finding a way to get a shoulder up in the middle of the ring there, though. These two men had their issues before. Tonight coming to a head here. Dave DuPont offering the Milwaukee Mahler $10,000 to take out Justin Rhodes. Mahler lining up for a catapult into the bottom rope. Once again attacking that trachea. Once again attacking that windpipe. Trying to stop Justin Rhodes from breathing. Mahler already proved his loyalty earlier on by attacking Viper Pete Christie. And even earlier in the night, Malachi Mahler came out helping Dave DuPont to win a dark match against Doink the Clown by attacking Doink the Clown with a chain. Mahler surviving that sunset flip attempt. Now he's instituting a camel clutch here in the middle of the ring. No place for Justin Rhodes to go. No way to escape. This one might just about be over. Mahler looks to rearrange the facial features of Justin Rhodes. He releases the hold, though. Mahler releases the hold on Rhodes. And that's going to be a mistake, it looks like, here, because now Rhodes is taking that opportunity to come back, slugging away at Mahler with some right hands and a bionic elbow. That could be it. After the bionic elbow. Bionic elbow, one of the trademarks of the Rhodes family, and that almost had Mahler beat right there. Mahler probably wishing that he had kept hold of that camel clutch right about now as he walks right into an inverted atomic drop off the ropes now. Rhodes looking for the bulldog, but it's thrown off by Mahler. And here comes Doink the Clown. Doink slides into the ring now. He's looking for retribution, I'll bet. And yes, he does. He goes right after Milwaukee Mahler. Pummeling away at Mahler in the corner. And they're going to throw this match out. Doink the Clown coming out, getting some retribution after Milwaukee Mahler cost him that dark match against Dave DuPont earlier on tonight. Mahler reversing that bulldog attempt. Looking like he had the advantage in the matchup. But now this match is going to have to be thrown out. As Doink the Clown comes out the top rope, hitting up. Seated splash onto Mahler's chest. Justin Rhodes seems content to let these two battle it out. As Mahler once again takes a tumble over the top rope, falling to the outside after doing a full gainer in reverse over the top rope. Doink the Clown continuing his assault here on the outside. Mahler fighting back with right hands, but Doink the Clown still has the advantage. These two are battling back towards our backstage area, towards our entryway, and we will be right back with more Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Masked Grappler standing in the middle of the ring right now. He's issued a challenge to Big Chuck Wagon for a match here tonight. Chuck Wagon has accepted the challenge. As we await the arrival of a perennial crowd favorite here in Bay City, this man, Big Chuck Wagon. It could be a battle of two big men here. And Chuck Wagon's coming out with an entourage here. What I can only assume must be his kin. There's one trait that I can see that must be genetic. Like I said though, this is a battle of the big men. Masked Grappler. Well over 300 pounds himself, or is this Chuck Wagon? It's 500, which I can only assume is also true for his pal in the green shirt there. There we go in this battle of super heavyweights. Masked Grappler coming right off the bat as Chuck Wagon's being checked. Assaulting Chuck Wagon immediately. Grappler sending Chuck across the ring, hitting a big right hand, but he can't topple the 500 pounder. jumping kick to the sternum does take Chuck Wagon down. Mass Grappler tries for the three count, but only gets two. Grappler positions Chuck Wagon over the second rope, trying to choke him out there. I think you have to be able to find his neck to choke him out, though. Grappler stomps away. Once again tries for the choke in the corner. Grappler jawjacking with the referee, but gets knocked right on his back. Plus he gives Chuck Wagon time to recover. Grappler doesn't seem to have given away the advantage too much, though, as Wheeler hadn't recovered yet. Chuck Wagon blocks two Irish rope attempts, and then Wagon comes across the ring, hitting a huge avalanche splash. Oh no. A grappler has fallen in the corner, and that's going to set him up for the stink face from Chuck Wagon. Big Chuck Wagon rubbing that big 500-pound redneck ass of his right on the face of Mass Grappler. Even with that mask on, it's got to smell hideous. Oh, it's got to feel disgusting and filthy. And a leg drop by Wagon. Big Chuck Wagon calling for the steamroller. The fans want to see it. Nearly gets a three count. Thumb to the eye by the Mask Grappler, backing Big Chuck Wagon up into the corner. Slapping him across the chest with both hands. Reversed once again on that Irish whip attempt. Wagon trying to get up a lot of steam, runs all the way across the ring, misses the charge. And the grappler goes low on Wagon. Mass Grappler leans outside of the ring, slapping this other large man right in the face. Now the Mass Grappler going up top. Going for the moonsault. Wagon moves out of the way. That was a very impressive moonsault there by the Mass Grappler. But it only served to drive all the air right out of him as he missed Chuck Wagon. Now Chuck Wagon's going to the top rope himself. And I tell you, anything that Chuck Wagon does from the top rope is going to spell the end for his opponent. That's got to be all. Two, three, that's it. Big splash off the top. There's no way you're going to kick out after a 500-pound man dives on you from 6 feet in the air. And Big Chuck Wagon is victorious in this battle of super heavyweights. What was that? Gunshot?
We got family business to talk about. You come with me. No.
Family business to talk about. Oh, more Chuck Wagon's inbred family, I'll bet. And I am as confused as you are, folks. Chuck Wagon's family issues making their way into Ultimate Championship Wrestling.
Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. Just before our break, all hell broke loose as some hillbilly came out into the arena firing a gun off into the air after Chuck Wagon had defeated the Masked Grappler. Chuck Wagon seemed very distraught as the man took away his girlfriend or cousin or both away from ringside. I have no idea what's going on here. But I do know that we have a new Cruiserweight champion in Jason Young, who defeated Scott Devin earlier tonight. And I do know that the Rainbow Warriors defeated the Connecticut Experience in another action. And I know that Doink the Clown broke up a $10,000 bounty match between Milwaukee Molly and Justin Miller. And I also know that it is time for our main event. It's going to be Mayhem, Defender, their KOT title, against the Viper Pete Christie and Gary Corrigan. Coming up right now on Ultimate Team.
And here come our tag team champions, Nitro and Chainsaw, collectively known as Mayhem, and along with the man leading them to the ring there, Dave DuPont, known as The Exchange. The Exchange, led by Dave DuPont. His team Mayhem, managed by him. And they have a formidable unit. Nitro scoffing at a fan, at heckling him at ringside. And this is quite a main event halfway right here back. Tonight. Mayhem defending their tag team titles once again, like I said, against the Viper Pete Christie and Big Bull Wheeler. Dave DuPont making his way to the back again for some reason. Nitro and Chainsaw assaulting a fan out here at ringside. Well, I don't know about that. Those guys could be risking suspension for attacking that fan. Here comes Dave DuPont back out. I think it must be that's the fight for Pete Christie's hat. Dave DuPont must have taken that from him earlier tonight after the Exchange delivered that vicious assault. And Pete Christie in our opening segment of the night. There goes that fan right there. The fan's probably going to be given some forms to file out a complaint against Mayhem. Here come your challengers, the Viper Pete Christie and Big Bull Wheeler. These guys, both from Bay City. Of course, this Bay City crowd loves them. Pete Christie has had his issues with the Exchange since they first formed. Especially Dave DuPont. And earlier tonight, those ever come to a head when they've just totally beat the living crap out of Pete Christie. Chair shots and capping it off with that big splash from Nitro off the top rope. Bull Wheeler, his issues with the Exchange started last week. Dave DuPont came out, ragged on Bay City, Bull Wheeler came to his aid. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. This tag team title match been underway for the last couple of minutes. It's been back and forth, but right now it looks like the team, the challengers, the Viper Pete Christie and Bull Wheeler, taking the advantage right now. Pete Christie working an arm bar and that left arm a chainsaw. Pete Christie asking the crowd, do you want me to break it? Reversal by Chainsaw now. Reversed by Pete Christie. And he's got a hold of that left arm again and he tags in his partner, Bull Wheeler. Bull Wheeler into the ring now. Pete Christie directs him to grab that other arm so he can deliver a Irish whip followed by a double clothesline. Bull Wheeler off the ropes now. It's a rolling senton bomb. Chainsaw kicks out at two, however. And it looks like Pete Christie and Bull Wheeler came in here with a plan tonight, and that plan was to attack the left arm of Chainsaw here. And they are working it to a T as they have been relentless ever since they gained the advantage. They have been relentless at working on that arm. You can see Bull Wheeler has a hold of it right now as he tags in Pete Christie. And okay, Pete Christie's gonna take over now. He's gonna take some shots at that left shoulder. He's hammering away. Pete Christie. They can chainsaw whipping him off the ropes and arm dragging the left arm now. Christie wrenching that arm. Nitro, to be chainsaw, busts out with a punch to the stomach. Now sitting with a front face lock, hitting a vertical suplex. Chainsaw might want to think about tagging out right now. And he does. Very wisely, as he's been taking some punishment over the last few minutes. Tagging out to Nitro. Nitro on the ring now. Slugging away at the Viper Pete Christie. Christie reverses in the corner, though, and he sends Nitro across the ring. Christie charges in, hits a big, charging back elbow. And he knocks Dave Dupont off the apron. He had no cause for that, though. Dave Dupont is a registered manager. It's totally legal for him to be down here at ringside. He's both an active wrestler and a manager. No reason to knock him off the apron there. Boo Wheeler hitting that leg drop now. On the arm, once again, this team of Boo Wheeler and Viper Pete Christie doing a spectacular job of working over the left arm of their opponents. Of course, they got to be wishing that Chainsaw hadn't been able to tag out of this match. They could have just continued working on him and gotten the win without ever having Nitro in this matchup. Chainsaw breaking up that arm bar. Being sent back into the corner. Wheeler tags out to Viper Pete Christie. Christie now in. Irish whip reversal. Chainsaw with a knee to the back. Nitro drops an elbow across the kidneys of the Viper Pete Christie in a second. And the kidneys, right in the ribs even. Those ribs that were injured earlier by the exchange. As they assaulted Viper Pete Christie during our opening segment, as I was talking about earlier. Assaulting him with the chair. Nitro hitting that big splash off the top rope. Nitro hawks a loogie in Bull Wheeler's direction. Bull Wheeler, upset by that, tries to charge into the ring, but he's held back by the referee. This allows both members of Mayhem to enter the ring and deliver a double team assault, a double team shoulder block on Pete Christie. He falls hard on his back, probably taking a lot of impact on those ribs. Camel clutch now by Chainsaw. There's no place for Viper Pete Christie to go. His only chance is for Bull Wheeler to come in and break this up. Or for Chainsaw to get bored with the maneuver and let it go. You know, that sort of impatience can only hurt you. There's no way that Viper Pete Christie was going to get out of that maneuver unless Chainsaw let him go. And Chainsaw let him go. If he had been patient, he could have wrenched that move in until Viper Pete Christie had to submit. Cocky pin now by Nitro. And that's not going to get the job done. Now Nitro locking in a camel clutch, and in comes Chainsaw, the Ed and the Boston Crab together. They call that move the Devil's Arch. Devil's Arch, just a horrendously vicious double team maneuver there. Chainsaw tosses Pete Christie to the outside. Now Dave Dupont getting in on the action. Getting in the action illegally, but referee had his back turned. Another chair shot to the ribs of Pete Christie. Two. Dave DuPont now slugging away at the kidneys of Viper Pete Christie, right in front of the referee chastising him for it. Referee's not going to disqualify him over that, though. But with the championship advantage, Mayhem will retain the titles anyway. So the challengers would not be too happy with that disqualification victory, because it would mean no tag titles for him. Challengers only want to win by pinfall or submission. Nitro charging in, hitting that knee to the head of Viper Pete Christie, sending the back of his head into that second turnbuckle pad now, delivering a double underhook suplex. A lot of elevation on that double underhook suplex by Nitro there. He's wasting time with the humanoids out there. Instead of going for a good cover and hooking a leg, could have been the end of that match. He doesn't even hook the leg after stalling and making the cover. Off the ropes goes Pete Christie, and he hits a DDT. Nitro telegraphed a back body drop. He ended up getting his head slammed right into the canvas by a Viper Pete Christie DDT. Pete Christie now slowly crawling over to the corner. Looks like he's going to get this tag. He's going to get the tag to Bull Wheeler. Gets that tag. Bull Wheeler now coming into the match. Charging in towards Nitro. Oh, with the ref. I think the ref's back was turned. He didn't see that. Didn't see that tag being made, and it was a silent tag too. So he didn't even hear it being made. So he had no knowledge of that tag being made. He had to send Bull Wheeler back to the other side of the ring. Bear hug now by Chainsaw. Almost got a fall out of it. Christie just able to keep his arm up on that third drop. Chainsaw can't hold Christie up anymore. He's holding him up there for nearly a minute. I think the Viper Pete Christie just bit Chainsaw's forehead to get himself free of that situation. In comes Nitro to deliver an elbow to the ribs. Once again, sprawling Pete Christie out on the mat. Nitro with a shot to Bull Wheeler, nearly knocking him off the apron. Wheeler holds on by one hand. Nitro now throwing Pete Christie around like a rag doll, hitting a double rib breaker over his right knee. Nitro stepping on the throat of the Viper Pete Christie. Christie's shoulders were on the mat since Nitro was attacking his throat at the moment. Referee could not make a pinfall count. Nitro just tagged out the Chainsaw there, and they're double-teaming Viper Pete Christie now. Nitro sends Chainsaw towards Christie. Christie ducked out of the way there. Now he's got a roll-up. Well, I think it's a two-count, though. I think Chainsaw was the legal man there. Of course, referee may have figured that if both members of Mayhem decided they wanted to be in the ring at the same time, that Viper Pete Christie could pin either one of them. Bull Wheeler now in the ring. He's being used as a human battering ram, being rammed right into the stomachs of both members of Mayhem. Mayhem deciding to take a breather here as Bull Wheeler finally gets back into this matchup. Wheeler's not going to let him have that time off, though, as he dives outside, and so does the Viper Pete Christie. Christie fighting with Chainsaw on one side. Here comes Dave DuPont to double-team Pete Christie. Nitro and Wheeler batting that on the other side. Pete Christie just sent Dave DuPont's face right into the steel ring post. But here comes Chainsaw now. He tosses Pete Christie into the bleachers. Christie taking a seat in the bleachers there. Now he's back up. He says, "No, you have a seat here, Chainsaw. You're not supposed to sit on your face, though." Nitro tossing bully that through the crowd. Now Chainsaw with a double axe handle smash to the back of Viper Pete Christie, and the champions have a huge advantage here on the outside, taking it to their challengers. Nitro rolls Pete Christie back into the ring, Chainsaw chasing him back in there. Bull Wheeler, Nitro going through the crowd. Wheeler just threw Nitro's face first into the wall, but here comes Dave DuPont assaulting Bull Wheeler with that steel chair. Chainsaw and Viper Pete Christie in the ring now. Wheeler, after taking those steel chair shots, laying on the outside. He takes one steel chair shot and another. I think Bull Wheeler has just been removed from this equation via Nitro and a steel chair. Viper Pete Christie with a low blow, though. Oh, what a nasty low blow by Viper Pete Christie. He's looking for a superplex now. He wants to finish this off before Nitro can get back in the ring. Dave DuPont, though, does not allow that superplex to happen. And Viper Pete Christie gets shoved off the top rope. And this could be the end. Bull Wheeler's out of it on the outside. Viper Pete Christie being left alone with both members of Mayhem. And here comes the super power slam. That's gotta be it. And it is. The champions retain. The champions retain. Viper Pete Christie and Bull Wheeler put up a valiant effort, but in the end, Mayhem comes through. Welcome back to Ultimate Championship Wrestling. The action has not ended out here yet. You see the replay of what occurred during our tag team title match from moments ago. Viper Pete Christie just name dropped the dog faced gremlin Rick Steiner.
If you guys think you got the guts, and I don't think you do, what is it? Let's have a little Bay City bunkhouse, Brawl Royal, anything you want, buddy. What do you think?
I've got a better idea.
There's only three of them. Four of us.
How about Viper Pete Christie laying out a challenge?
An eight-man Survivor-style elimination tag team match. But wait a minute! Even if you do get the Chihuahua face gremlin, the guy that went to that loser University of Michigan, the guy that went to that loser high school, Western High School, the guy that's from this loser backwards town, Rick Steiner.
Oh, there's there's El Diablo. The exchange thought they had put El Diablo out for good. And the Diablo's back out here now. Apparently he's accepted the spot on the fight for Pete Christie's team for this matchup against the exchange. There's going to be some sort of Ultimate Survivors matchup. All UCW superstars now hitting the ring. Just hammering away at each other. It's like a battle royale out here. Doink the Clown out now, battling with Nitro. Chuck Wagon's in there, the Cruiserweight Champion Jason Yang. I thought I saw him. Connected Experience coming out. Huge news though. Ultimate Survivor match being set up. 4-on-4, the exchange against a bunch of guys from Bay City, Team Bay City, I guess you can call them. Fight for Pete Christie, Bull Wheeler, El Diablo, and apparently the dog-faced gremlin, Rick Steiner. I just want to know, when is this match going to take place, because I can't wait for it.